give Patrick Power on Skype with us all the way from Finland, from Arctic Star Exploration. Patrick, I understand from your Timantti diamond project, this is the highest diamond count you've ever found in Finland before. You announced this yesterday.
Correct, Christine. We believe it's the best diamond count ever to come out of Finland, which is exciting for us because it's very early in our exploration of this property, and it's a great start. There is going to be a lot more kimberlites found, we believe, and a lot more diamond counts to come out of them, but we're very pleased with the first result.
How many diamonds did you find?
76 out of 99 kilos of kimberlite, which is very good. I think the largest stone was a millimeter, which is getting close to commercial. So out of a very small sample, that's a very good result. We will need to take a bigger sample, maybe 1,000 kilos to get diamond counts out of that to understand and project the larger stone population. And if that looks good, we can start talking about feasibility.
Can you kind of talk about the timeline for that? You still need to acquire some more tonnage and tell me what the timeline for that is.
Well, the timeline, the great thing about Finland is we can work year round. Unlike Canada, where in the high Arctic, there's a very limited season to drill, to sample. We can get in year round, other than spring breakup, which is kind of like a boat now, but for only 2 or 3 weeks. Otherwise, we're on road. I believe one of our kimberlites is 400 meters off a paved road. So it's very accessible, and we'll be back in there drilling, taking more sample in approximately 6 to 8 weeks. In the meantime, we're doing geophysics to identify more targets in the same area. And, you know, we believe this is a new field. And from the information we see coming from the Russian side and the trains coming back into Finland, we believe it's about 80 kilometers in width. And we've taken ground around the original Timantti claims. So the original Timantti claims were, I believe, 243 hectares. We've taken close to 200,000 hectares around that. And that would allow us to, we think, encompass the entire field. So fields run from generally 30 kimberlites to over 300, as Lochte Graa does. And we're in the very early stages of a big field with great chemistry. That's the big thing. Chemistry really does give you an idea what kind of diamond counts you're going to get. And not as much on the quality side, but quantity for sure. So we're excited about the future. And we'll be taking more sample in 6 to 8 weeks.
So it is pretty remarkable that you only started this 10 months ago and you've already found this many.
Yeah, and it's largely based on the team of people we have working on this. Roy Spencer, who found the grid pipe in Russia, which is worth several billion dollars, is leading this project. He had this project earlier with a company called European Diamonds, and Buddy was working with him on that company as well. So we have the same people that originally discovered in the 2004, 5, 6 era. And that all ended with the 2008 crisis, financial crisis. So it sat dormant until we regathered and came back at it. And they had just started it and had success, but they were in the first baby stages of the program. So we took it over and immediately had success. We found 4 more kimberlites in the last 3 months. And that's almost 100% success ratio of the targets we drilled. And there's a lot of targets out. It's target rich. And it's got great chemistry. So we expect good things on an ongoing basis in the future. As I said, you can work year round here. So we don't believe the program's only limited by the money you have, because you can work anytime.
Exciting times ahead, Patrick. Thank you so much for talking with us, and keep us updated.
Thanks, Christine. You're welcome.